single mum returning to study and feeling that little bit nervous? Well, I've got some tips to share. Okay, so my tip number one is don't have too much going on at once. Prioritize your activities, which means what can you drop? Like, I know you love netball, but do you really need to be doing netball right now with study and being a mum? You know, even think about how much social media you're using a day. Like that time where you're scrolling on Facebook, that could be used studying. That anything you do, like that series you really want to watch, I know it's tempting and everyone's talking about it, but that's awesome study time that, you know, you're missing out on when you could be studying. Tip number two is stay up that little bit longer or wake up that little bit earlier so you got time to study without kids. Now, what I was doing when I was studying for exams was I would get up an hour before my kids usually wake up and I'd have a cup of coffee and I'd get my exam revision out and I'll just go full into it because I know the kids aren't going to wait for another hour and there's no distraction, and it was just the perfect time to study. Tip number three is so important but so simple. Know who your support people are. So that might be your partner, your mum, your dad, your best friend, whatever. It's just really important to know the people that are supporting you through your education and parenting journey. Number four, I feel like I've talked about this a little already, but something has to give. It could mean housework, sporting activities. You can't do everything. You can be a good mum and you can study, but you can't always be a good mum, have an immaculate house with, you know, it looks like you haven't even lived in it, and study, and, you know, plus play netball, plus do the soccer runs with the kids on the weekends and stuff. Something has to give, and for me that was housework. When I study, my house does not look immaculate. It looks very lived in and there's clutter and mess, but you know what, I'm passing my classes, I'm either fed, they're happy, and that is the main thing. Tip number five, don't take on more than you can handle. Consider only doing one or two subjects a semester. I'm only doing two at the moment and I am loving it because I feel like that's just enough for me to put 100% into both my subjects. I think if I was doing four, I wouldn't be doing as well because there's only so much I can remember on top of looking after kids, and two classes is just easier to handle than four. Consider maybe only taking on two classes, and then if you think that's really easy, you can do three next time or even four. See how you go the first semester. Tip number six. Does anyone you know really want to look after your kids and spend some time with them? Well, why not take advantage of that? I know a lot of family members that would take any opportunity to take the kids to the park or an hour or two, you know, quality time with them. So why wouldn't I take advantage of that? Use that time to study. Tip number seven. Don't worry about how you look. There is enough to worry about. There's not enough hours in the day to worry about straightening your hair before you get to class. Just, you know, take the kids where they need to go, or worry about prepping things for the babysitter, and don't use that time straightening your hair. Tip number eight, make friends, and even better, make mummy friends, because you guys could have play dates, the kids could play, and you could be studying. Perfect combination. Tip number nine, if your child's in childcare anyway, consider putting them in childcare a day when you don't have uni or TAFE or whatever that day, because that is valuable study time. I know last semester I had my youngest child in childcare on the Thursday, and that's my uni day, but the problem is I only had a small amount of study time between my classes that I could utilize. Now this semester I'm going to put him in the Friday as well because I've got my classes on Thursday, and that way I can use my Friday to study. Tip number 10 is so simple but so important, guys. Look after yourself, seriously. Like, it can be so hard being like a working mum, a studying mum, a mum in general, but you really need to look after yourself and drink lots of water and eat small frequent meals, especially, you know, to get through that stress. And you're running around, you're burning lots of fuel, and study can make you so hungry, and just right choices instead of the wrong ones can make all the difference in energy. And yeah, just look after yourselves, and it's really easy sometimes to make quick smoothies by chucking everything you like in a smoothie into a Ziploc bag, freezing it, and then getting it out when you need to make a smoothie. It's just my favorite. Tip number 11 is to use stress to your advantage. Now, we all get stressed. There's no way to get around the, especially being a mum as well. I think the best thing to do is to use it as a motivator, use it to do better, use it to not get slack or, you know, spend time on social media. Use it as an advantage. And also, water has been my best friend with stress. The more water I drink, the better I feel, and also the better I eat, the better I handle stress. So yeah, go around it the right way and use stress as motivation, guys. And also see how you felt the semester before. If you know you felt like you took on those four classes and it was just too much, drop a couple classes next semester. It might make a world of difference. Or maybe you felt two classes were just too easy for you and you could take on more. Well, pick up an extra class next semester. Happy studying, and thank you for watching. See you next time.